Technology Me podcast is finally back.
This is Starwolf Duty, aka Perfect Welch.
Yep. Episode 4.
The RMG podcast.
Me.
So, what are we talking about today? James Ellsworth got released.
Oh, yes. This is some good news, though.
Yeah, this is the greatest news I've heard in years. I mean, like, I am just so flattered. I don't even know what to say.
But,
I don't know. It's just something so amazing, man.
Yeah, like, it was just how basically like the last couple of weeks he was getting beat up by the friggin' women there. Becky Lynch was beating the shit out of him. Friggin' Lana was beating the shit out of him. Charlotte was beating the shit out of him. Everyone was beating the shit out of him.
Yeah, it's like, what was this guy's point? He was nothing but a hindrance to the company.
Yeah. He's like any friggin' Dick Grayson joke can get in the ring and wrestle.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just put out this guy here and he doesn't... looks like a joke to wrestling.
Yeah. It's like, come on, just... what was the point of even having him in the first place?
I don't know.
He did nothing to contribute to WWE. He just came and went.
Yeah.
He was there for like... I don't even think he was there for a year.
Basically, Vince McMahon got bored over because of his promo. He cut Raw or Smart Show and said, two fighting mans with... Well, I don't know what the fuck how the promo went. He said, two mans with a fighting hand can have a chance or something like that. Some stupid stuff like that there.
Yeah. But hey, at least he's gone so we don't have to worry.
Yeah.
You know, let's talk about when WWE was great, or at least another time, because this is like the sequel to the Attitude Era. In a sense, in some sort of sense. And it's about the Ruthless Aggression Era.
Yeah, Ruthless Aggression Era.
When the brand split began, you know, we had the brand split between Raw and SmackDown. SmackDown had really cool guys like Kurt Angle and Brock, and Raw had great guys like Triple H, Shawn Michaels, and, you know, vice versa. Both Raw and SmackDown were great during the time.
Besides, yeah, more people to pull from at that time. There was more star power there, for frig's sakes. Yeah.
More people, more star power. And for the time, yeah, it's... for the earlier years, you kind of had Hulk Hogan, The Rock, Stone Cold. But I think my favorite Ruthless Aggression Era guys were, you know, Triple H, Shawn Michaels, you know, I like Jeff Hardy, I like Edge and Christian, you know, as always.
I like Goldberg. Goldberg was a shit.
Yeah, Goldberg was. Sadly, his run, same with Scott Steiner, their runs in WWE weren't as good as their runs in, WCW, but you know.
Yeah. Steiner should have cut more promos that he did there, like those freaking off, those funny promos. I like his promos. Their promos are the best there.
Yeah, I know, man. I know. Especially that match he had with Triple H. That was terrible.
Yeah. It was just like the Steiner match that fucking kept suplexing the damn guy.
Yeah.
And then there's underwear showing that, something like that there.
Yeah. That's his worst match. Even he freaking hates the match.
That's interesting. Besides, who... well, he had, like, he had more... he had the... Randy Orton was better at that time in Ruthless Aggression Era.
Mm-hmm.
Batista was a friggin'... Batista was an animal. Holy shit, Batista was good in that era.
Oh, Brock Lesnar.
Yeah.
Don't forget Brock. Kurt Angle. Batista and Randy Orton. I like Batista and Randy Orton at that time. They were in their prime during 2002 to 2008, and that's a fact.
Yeah. Batista, there, he was a good wrestler at that time.
Yeah, really good. He had many great feuds with Edge and Undertaker and Triple H and John Cena. You know, those are my personal favorites, in my opinion.
I like the matches that he had, though.
Yeah. I mean, you know, he was really good. And he's a great movie actor.
Yeah.
It's good he left WWE for Hollywood.
Yeah.
Just like Rock. They're both too good.
Yeah. WWE doesn't deserve Batista or The Rock.
Exactly.
Fuck, you're lucky to even have them, for freak's sakes.
Yeah.
That's one point. Yeah.
And it was when they were good.
Yeah, that's so when the product was.
Respect about those two over Stone Cold. Like, people say, oh, Batista and Rock are jerks. Well, at least you're not complete sellouts like Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Yeah.
Like, I don't have anything against the guy personally. He seems like he could be a nice guy, but dude, you're a sellout. You sold out so much. I mean, I know Corey already said it, so it's redundant, but you sold out more than you did at WrestleMania freaking 17.
Yeah. Besides them.
That's saying a lot. At least the moment was great. The moment here sucks.
Yeah. Besides the matches I liked from the Ruthless Aggression was the match at WrestleMania between Mick Foley and Edge. Holy God, that was an amazing match. That was the best match that Mick Foley and Edge had. Their friggin' hardcore flaming tables, blood and guts. It was a good match.
I mean, I don't know if I'd say that's Edge's greatest match, but it's definitely one of his greatest. I mean,
yeah.
It's kind of hard to say what Edge's greatest match is, but I think my favorite match of that was my favorite Mick Foley match out of all of them. Even the ones he had, like Cactus Jack versus Triple H at WrestleMania 2000 versus The Rock at the I Quit Royal Rumble 1999 match, or even the one that's most like the Hell in a Cell match at King of the Ring 1998.
Yeah.
Those three combined don't top that match.
No, they don't.
In my opinion. I'm sorry. I know people might get mad at me, but that's just my opinion.
Okay. Besides, I like...
I think that was his last match at the time.
Yeah.
I think that was his last WWE match at the time. I could be wrong, but yeah.
Besides, I like the match that Mick Foley and Randy Orton had a pretty good match also there.
Yeah.
It wasn't that a good match that it was at the time. There was the Elimination Chamber at Survivor Series. That was another good one. 02 there, when you had all the big major stars in it there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Chris Jericho was still a star during this time.
Yes, true.
Yeah, Chris Jericho. Yeah, some good matches with Benoit and...
Shawn Michaels.
Yeah, Shawn Michaels. Oh, yeah. It was like, what was that match he had at 19? That match with Shawn Michaels, yeah. That was really good. What about Edge versus Taker?
That was another good one.
SummerSlam.
There was that ladder match with the Hardys and Eminem and that there. Like, yeah. Where a friggin' machine took the ladder and broke, like, his machine. Holy frick, it was pretty crazy. That was a good match, too.
Yeah, I still say that, you know, the Hardys' best match were the TLC match at WrestleMania 17 they had with the Dudleys and Eden C. The best, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Best tag team match ever.
Yeah, it was the best tag team match.
Or that any of the six ever had.
Yeah. Okay, what else we can say or give a wrap up there? Besides, another thing I like to say, was the Cruiserweight division was better on the Ruthless Aggression era, way better than what we got on Raw.
I know.
Friggin' Ultimate Dragon was there at the time, Chujiri, Rey Mysterio, I don't know if Rey Mysterio, Kid Cash was there, Super Crazy Psychosis, a bunch of them. Brian Kendrick, Paul London.
Yeah.
Shane Moore, Gregory Helms.
Rey Mysterio. Oh, and let's not forget Brock Lesnar. I think SummerSlam 2002 was my, like, favorite,
Lesnar match
ever. Yeah, Lesnar versus Rock and Triple H versus Shawn Michaels were 5 out of 5 star matches. You know, Kurt Angle, Rey Mysterio's first pay-per-view match, and pretty much every match on the card was great. I mean, when the weakest match, Taker versus, Test, which is a 3.6, is a good match, an above average match.
He's yes.
That, in my opinion. You know you have a great freaking pay-per-view. I mean, and the only problem I really had with that one is that I thought it was a little too short.
Yes. Besides, the match I liked was Undertaker. It was the Triple H and Michaels match. That was a pretty good one. Lesnar Rock was pretty good. It was like Rock passing the torch to Lesnar, basically.
Yeah.
It was like Attitude Era versus Ruthless Aggression in that match.
Yeah. I mean, especially when you consider the fact that just a few pay-per-views earlier, he had a match with Hulk Hogan, which could be considered Golden Era versus,
Ruthless.
Yeah.
Anyway, this is the RMG Mini Podcast.
And this is Star Wolf Dude, aka Perfect Welch, signing out. You have a great day.
Killer J, see you guys later. Bye.